हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज क्लास सिक्स हेलो डॉयच मॉड्यूल वन लेक्सन ड्राई। क्लास सिक्स के ऊपर ऑलरेडी वीडियो बन चुके हैं, आप देख सकते हो उन वीडियोज को। मॉड्यूल वन लेक्सन ड्राई। हाज टू गेस विस्टर, डू यू हैव सिबलिंग्स? इन द प्ले लिस्ट यू कैन फाइंड ऑल द वीडियोज ऑफ क्लास सिक्स। आई विल गिव द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। डिस्क्रिप्शन में आपको लिंक मिल जाएगा प्ले लिस्ट का, पूरी वीडियोज आप देख सकते हो। सिबलिंग्स मीन्स गेस विस्टर। Do you have guest sister? This is the name of the chapter. So in this chapter we learn numbers, salan, interview text. You have to write a small text about a person. Then adjectives, question making, politeness, fragabilden, höflich, z form, and indefinite article eine or einen. And in the end we see heisen and sein verb conjugation. So you can see on the screen, there is a boy named Rohan. So this is the information we have received first. 8, eine Schwester, telephone. So we have to write a text about this boy. Like, das ist Rohan. Ist 8 Jahre alt. Hat eine Schwester. Seine Telefonnummer ist 22 34 40. That means, this is Rohan. He is 8 years old. He has a sister. His telephone number is 223440. So these are the three points you can see here below. And on the basis of these points, we have written few lines about this boy, Rohan. So similarly, you have to write small text or few lines in the test also. This kind of pictures and information is given in your textbook, Hello Deutsch. Now, what is interview? Like, there are questions, 5, and you have to write the suitable answer, or you have to frame question answer round. Like, wie heißt du? Ich heiße Rohan. Wie alt bist du? Ich bin 8 Jahre alt. Hast du Geschwister? Ja, ich habe eine Schwester. Wie viele Geschwister hast du? Ich habe eine Schwester. Okay, third and fourth question almost same. Do you have siblings or how many siblings you have? So these two questions are almost same. There is no difference. Meaning is same. Wie ist deine Telefonnummer? Meine Telefonnummer ist, then you can write. So how are you called? How old are you? Do you have siblings? How many siblings you have? And what is your telephone number? We say, what is your telephone number? But in German, wie ist, how is your telephone number? This is very important. Students make mistakes. Then we have adjective. You can see few adjectives here. Nett, lustig, sympathisch, freundlich, sportlich, doof, faul, langweilig, streng, laut. Meanings are also given. Nice means net. Lustig is funny. Sympathisch, sympathetic. Freundlich means friendly. Sportlich, sporty. Doof, idiot. Foul, lazy. Langweilig, boring. Streng, strict. And loud means loud, noisy. So these are the vocabulary. You will find this entire sheet in the link. I will give the link in the description. You can see this entire documents, okay, in the link. So no need to write. You can just click the link and you can download this. Now, wie ist deine Schwester? Now you have to fill the blanks. Means you have to write the suitable adjective. Suppose we say, wie ist deine Schwester? So answer will be, meine Schwester ist freundlich. My sister is friendly. So this is the way we use the adjective. Is tarah se hum adjective ko use karenge. How is your sister? My sister is friendly. Wie ist dein Vater? How is your father? My father is nett. Means my father is very nice. So this way we can use question and answer form with the help of adjective. Ist dein Freund freundlich? Ist dein Freund freundlich? Is your friend friendly? 9. Mein Freund ist unfreundlich, unfriendly. He is not friendly. So we have used these adjectives here, as you can see, in the question answer frame. Next is Gegenteil. Gegenteil means opposite words. Net, opposite arrogant, arrogant. Freundlich, opposite unfreundlich, unfriendly. Doof, opposite intelligent. Sportlich, unsportlich. Langweilig, boring. Interessant, interesting. Sympathisch, sympathetic. Unsympathisch. Verheiratet means married. And this is ledig, single. Or unverheiratet, unmarried. So this is called Gegenteil, opposite. This is very important in this chapter. You can learn from here. The next topic is Fragebilden. How to make questions. This is the thing that you will get in every chapter, either in class 6, 7th or 8th, in all classes, in all the chapters. This is Fragebilden question. You have to make questions. Answers are given. You have to make questions. And this is very important from the test and exam point of view. So first is, Ich heiße Rohan, means I am called Rohan. So what is the question? Wie heißen Sie? How are you called? Sie. Second is, Ich bin der Vater von Tina. I am the father of Tina. And the question is, Wer sind Sie? Who are you? Wer sind Sie? Third number, 9. Ich bin die Tante von Tina. No, I am the aunt of Tina. And the question is, Sind Sie die Mutter von Tina? Okay. Sind Sie die Mutter von Tina? Are you the mother of Tina? The question is, no, I am the aunt of Tina. Next, number 4. Ja, ich bin Herr Bauer. Yes, I am Mr. Bauer. Question is, Sind Sie Herr Bauer? Are you Mr. Bauer? So this is called Jana in Frage. You can practice from the Arbeitsbuch. Similar questions are given. And the last we'll see conjugation. Conjugation of the verb sein and heißen. You know, sein means to be. In English we say to be. And heißen means to be called. Okay. So these are the two verbs that is important in this chapter. Ich bin, I am. Ich heiße, I am called. Du bist, you are. Du heißt, you are called. Sie ist, he is, she is. Or heißt, he is called. Wir sind, we are. Wir heißen, we are called. Seid, you are, means you plural. This is plural, plural of du. Okay. And heißt, you both or maybe more than one, you are called. Similarly, this Z means you formal and this small is they. Okay. They. So Z sind you are or they are. Z heißen, they are called or you are called. But small and capital. Small means they, capital means you. Formal. So this is conjugation, very, very important. You can learn by heart. And now I have made some sentences. Ich heiße Rohan und bin 11 Jahre alt. I am Rohan and am 11 years old. So here you don't repeat ich again. Ich heiße Rohan und bin 11 Jahre alt. Similarly, heißt Sohan und ist 12 Jahre alt. He is called Sohan or his name is Sohan. He is Sohan. You can say anything. And is 12 years old. So this is the use of these verbs, sein and haben. How do I use? Heißen and sein. You can practice in your notebook. Then we have indefinite articles. Ein und einen. This is called indefinite articles. In German, we have two types of article. Definite and indefinite. But this is called indefinite article. This is again very important. Der Sohn einen. It means if the article is der, you will write einen. If article is D, you will write eine. So these two words are clear, and the meaning is ein und eine. Both means a or an. Okay. Like ich habe eine Schwester. Now you know Schwester article is D. So we say ich habe eine Schwester. I have one sister. So indefinite article eine, because sister article is D. So you will use eine. Similarly, Bruder article is der. Ich habe einen Bruder, because we have seen der takes einen. So this way you can learn further. If it's der, you will write einen. If it's D, you will simply say eine. So this is the concept. And if it's das, I am writing that also. It is again ein. So only you have to focus on der, which is important. Rohan has a brother. I have a sister. And again, nein, ich habe einen Bruder. So here einen, again einen, because Bruder is der. So this way you can move further. Und eine Schwester. And the last, we'll see articles. Vater, der. Die Mutter, die Oma, die Tante, der Onkel, der Freund, die Freundin. That's all in this video. I hope you liked it. In the description, you will find playlist and some more useful links of this document also. You will find the list. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Take care.